Donald Trump's words have sent shockwaves far beyond our borders. World leaders reacting. His business is taking a hit. There's even a petition circulating in the UK, nearly 600,000 signatures, that would ban Trump from traveling to England. But as our chief foreign correspondent Terry Moran reports, politicians across the developed world have also been echoing Trump's unvarnished populism.
That's Donald Trump's theme song, Dee Snider's We're Not Gonna Take It. It's the essence of his anti-establishment appeal. But Trump is not alone. In country after country, populist leaders are gaining ground, like Marine Le Pen in France, who's soaring in the polls with a Trumpian brew of anti-immigration policies and nationalism. In Hungary, Prime Minister Viktor Orban is sounding the same theme, and he's building a razor wire fence to keep Syrian refugees from flowing in. In Britain, there's Nigel Farage of the small UK Independence Party. But none have gone as far as Trump.
Donald J. Trump is calling for a total and complete shutdown of Muslims entering the United States.
That extremist proposal Trump unveiled this week shocked people around the world. In London,
it's not right. It's not fair to a million people, not just me.
In the West Bank.
The United States was built and founded based on immigrants.
In Paris.
I think it is very crazy.
In Dubai, they tore his name and face off a billboard at his golf course there. And British Prime Minister David Cameron called Trump's idea divisive, unhelpful, and quite simply wrong. U.S. officials and many others worry that Trump's proposal plays right into the hands of ISIS, who will use it for recruitment. Trump's Muslim ban was thrown into sharp relief Friday as Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau greeted a plane load of Syrian refugees.
You are home.
Thank you.
Welcome home.
But so far, being the Republican establishment's nightmare,
the establishment's got a problem,
is working just fine for Donald Trump.